Decided to play a game. We do it occasionally called Playoffs or Takeoff.
And now, Colin will decide if a team is headed for the playoffs.
Playoffs?
Or taking off for vacation.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Please turn yourself in securely.
It's Playoff or Takeoff.
All right, first team. Dallas Cowboys. Takeoff. They were 8-8 last year. They've got a new coach.
Prepare for takeoff.
This is a real easy one. They also lost very productive players. Robert Quinn, Randall Cobb, center Travis Frederick. It's not a playoff team. New York Giants, another easy one. Takeoff.
Flight crew, please prepare for takeoff.
Yeah. New coach, new coordinators, new system, young quarterback, and two teams in Dallas and Philadelphia significantly more talented. Not a playoff team. Philadelphia Eagles, playoffs, no question.
Playoffs?
Added Darius Slay, a corner at their weakest position, will also draft an influx of wide receivers. DeSean Jackson is back healthy. Fourth easiest schedule in the NFC. Two bad teams rebuilding in their division, Giants and Washington. And also, they started last year wobbly, but finished incredibly strong. I like their momentum. Washington Redskins, takeoff. We know that.
Flight crew, please prepare for takeoff.
They don't have a quarterback. That's not settled. They got a new coach. I do think their defensive front, if they draft Chase Young, is formidable, but that alone is not making you a playoff team. Chicago Bears, hate to say it, but takeoff, not playoff.
Flight crew, please prepare
for takeoff. Yeah, only made the playoffs once in the last decade. They do not have a first-round pick, and they need some offensive line help. Kyle Long retired. Last year, they played eight teams with a winning record, and they were 2-6. Both wins against Minnesota, a team they matched up well against. How about Detroit? That's an easy one. Takeoff.
Yeah. For takeoff.
Yeah. Matt Patricia is 9-22-1 as a head coach. They won 9 games 3 years ago, 6 games 2 years ago, and 3 games last year. And if you look at their schedule, second toughest in the NFC. Green Bay Packers. Good news, playoff team.
Playoffs?
I don't think this is terribly tough. 13-3 last year. Aaron Rodgers, last 11 years, 10 winning seasons. They also have the second most draft picks, 10 in the NFC. So they will shore up their defensive front and linebacking cores. They're going to be a playoff team. Minnesota, same thing.
Playoffs?
12 draft picks is the two first rounders. This is the way the smart teams work. Green Bay and Minnesota are good teams. And they both have a ton of draft picks. New England's been a good team. They got a ton of draft picks. Also, Kirk Cousins came off his best year. I think Minnesota, though they lost Everson Griffin and Stephon Diggs, still an argument, top three roster in the NFL. Atlanta Falcons, close, but I would say a takeoff there.
Please prepare for a takeoff.
First of all, they were lousy last year, almost last in the NFL in yards rushing a game. They did add Todd Gurley, but they lost Vic Beasley. They lost Austin Hooper. They lost Devontae Freeman. They lost Desmond Trufant. Their schedule with Tom Brady in the division is now arguably the hardest schedule in the entire NFC. Carolina Panthers, takeoff.
Yeah. Flight crew, please prepare for a takeoff.
I like their quarterback, Teddy B, and I like their coach. Luke Kuechly gone, Greg Olsen gone. Feels like a little bit of a rebuild. They could be the best fourth-place team in any division in the NFL, but they still feel like a fourth-place team. New Orleans Saints feels pretty good in a year we're battling the virus. No camps. I would say a playoff team for the Saints.
Playoffs?
I've doubted them for a long time, but the reality is they added two players I really like. Smart veteran players. Malcolm Jenkins at safety. Emmanuel Sanders. These are smart veterans, leaders on one on each side of the ball. They walk in immediately and have an impact. This is really smart. There's some spots where this team is young, but boy, wide receiver Emmanuel Sanders and Malcolm Jenkins, these are locker room guys in an already good locker room. They'll have an impact year one. Tampa Bay, Tommy's making the playoffs.
Playoffs?
They had 35 turnovers from the quarterback position. If they go down to 15 with all that young talent, they'll win. I do not think they'll have a great September. I think, like New England teams, they'll get much better late October, November, December, and January. Arizona, a lot to like, but Takeoff.
Flight crew, please prepare for Takeoff.
Division's brutal. Defense needs a lot of work. And let's be honest, they face Russell Wilson twice, Kyle Shanahan, Garoppolo twice, Sean McVay and Jared Goff twice. That's just a tough, they could be like the Cleveland Browns this year, where I like them, and I think they're better than last year significantly, and they finish in third or fourth place because the division's too tough. L.A. Rams, Takeoff.
Flight crew, please prepare for Takeoff.
Jared Goff, now the highest cap hit in the NFL. They lost Clay Matthews, Todd Gurley, Dante Fowler. Again, they remind me of the Cowboys, where I get a lot of stars, but they lose. I mean, if Aaron Donald got hurt, what kind of defense is that? I mean, honestly, what when you have very little depth, and they also don't have a lot of first-round picks, so they don't have a lot of guys that are they're going to draft and that are going to be huge impact guys. I do think their own line will be better this year because they suffered injuries guard, center, guard. San Francisco 49ers, I feel pretty safe saying playoff.
Playoffs?
Great coach. Jimmy Garoppolo's 21-5 as a starter. They also let go of DeForest Buckner to the Colts, but they have now two first-round picks. So they've shown a history of being able to land that first-round pick. So I think San Francisco is in a good spot. And I will say, I'm not a Seattle homer. I never see myself as a Seattle homer, but the Seahawks, I think maybe the most underrated team in the NFL playoff.
Playoffs?
Do we realize last year, if not for cluster injuries at running back, this was the one team in the NFC, Joy, that matched up with San Francisco in the playoffs? They added Greg Olsen. Quentin Dunbar is a very good corner. They've never had a losing season. I think we forget, because of that Green Bay game, they literally lost all their running backs and one of their offensive linemen. Seattle's ready to go. And their draft last year, they brought in like 7, 8 first, second, third, fourth round young guys. Looks like most can play. Hi, everybody. Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from the show. Also, be sure to check out more of the best clips from The Herd or go watch a few segments from other shows on FS1.